twisted like it's stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like it's stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like it's stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like it's stir fry.
I'll take a whip it intermission, let the birds fly. I get money, turn no vision through my third eye.
Well, hello, sweet babies. It's your girl, Ms.Carlababy, and welcome to my kitchen. You won't be seeing me during this video. This is just a cooking video. Some of you said you miss my cooking videos, and I do miss doing them. They don't get many views, but I don't care if it's five of y'all, whoever. I love my sweet babies, so even if five of y'all want to watch it, that's what I'm going to do for y'all. Just like I'm rocking a whole 1,000 viewers, you know what I'm saying? So this is what I got for y'all today. Today, I am making chicken Alfredo with a 3-cheese ravioli stuffed with spinach. And I'm going to do it the way that I don't have to make my own chicken breast, make my own ravioli, make my own sauce, you know. But I do make it homemade and I add my own twist to it. I love to eat for flavor. So the seasonings you can change to what you want to use for your season to season your food with. If you want a copy, go ahead. But this might be too much for you if you have medical problems in that area. So, some of the stuff I'm cooking with powders. So, some of the stuff will be salt and most of it is powder. So, but I do cook with salt. You know what I'm saying? Because my blood pressure is not an issue at this time. So, I'm cool on that. And my blood sugars, no, they're perfect. So, here we go, sweet babies. This is the seasonings I'll be using. I'll be using crushed red peppers, adobo seasoning, roasted garlic and herb, magic seasoning salt. It is New Orleans brand. I'll be using season all seasoning salt by Morton, onion powder, garlic powder, regular salt, black pepper, mustard powder, ground mustard, garlic, minced garlic, and accent. And also I will be using grated Parmesan cheese. Now over here I also have, for the seasonings, what I'll be using. I'm just showing y'all seasonings and stuff and the sauces right now. I'll be using 2% milk. I love the blue cap 2%. I'll be using extra virgin olive oil. This is vinegar in my bottle. I cook with vinegar with everything. This is Bertolli Alfredo sauce. I got a few bottles of those. And I will be using mozzarella cheese. And now, so the main things that I'm cooking it with. This is squash and zucchini that I will be making. I'll be sauteing and making. And with that, what I'll be doing, I roasted some potatoes like a week ago. Oh, I low roasted them for a very long time with some red, orange, and green, and what was it? Yellow bell pepper. And this is the results, and I froze them. So this is that. Look at all that goodness, all that seasoning and butter. I roasted them with butter and garlic. So they're butter garlic potatoes that I made homemade. Red potatoes. And I will be, this is some yellow onion that I chopped up and I freeze them. Yellow onion. I chop up onions ahead of time so I don't have to do it and freeze them. And this right here is just diced white chicken meat. Chicken breast meat with rib meat. Okay? So it'll be a little moist than breast meat. And I also have butter, imperial, margarine rather. I always cook with margarine. And the ravioli that I'll be using, here's the package right here. I bought it from a place called Swan that I always tell y'all about that I ordered from. And the chicken chunks also came from there. So let's get it started, sweet babies. We have over here on the stove. On the stove, here are the raviolis that we will be using. So I'll be over there in a minute. Right now, I'm going back over here to season the zucchini and squash. And you forgot the chicken broth. Okay. Just a minute, sweet babies. Sweet babies, hey, sweet babies, we back. The sliced onions is actually going to be for the for mostly the squash and the zucchini. I might put a little bit in the no, I won't put none. I ain't gonna put none in that. It don't need it. I'm gonna have much flavor in it. So anyway, here I go seasoning this right here. What I'm gonna use to season this is pepper, Did I tell y'all black pepper? I forgot. I think I did. Now, don't y'all hate on my black pepper. I love black pepper. Magic seasoning, the New Orleans seasoning. See, I use different seasons for different things. So, that's why different seasonings on there. Okay. And then, also, garlic powder. Onion powder. Little adobo. And we have that roasted garlic and herb. And make sure it's on a shaker. Don't want to fuck up because I do that sometimes. I do it a lot, actually. Then we had an accent to wake that motherfucking flavor up, y'all. Yeah. The accent waking up that flavor of everything. Now, this will usually come out on me all the time. The little thing come off at the top. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do with this is rub that around. Toss that around. Season all that up, y'all. Season that up. Welcome to my sweet babies. You got to season these vegetables up. You feel me? Y'all don't season the vegetables. Y'all kids don't want to eat them. You know? You got to make sure you get that pepper around because it'll be stuck on one of them. You feel me? You can add like a drop of olive oil too. But y'all already know what I'm going to add. Vinegar. Love vinegar. Love it. Love that vinegar, y'all. Vinegar is my go-to in the kitchen, y'all. I love it. Look how it makes that on. It's going to give it that little zing, zing, zing. Y'all already know. Y'all know. Look at them flavors blending together. Okay. That's all done and dander. That can sit up and just, you know. I'm about to change gloves. That's what I do, y'all. Okay, sweet baby. So, next what we're going to do, I got a little garbage bag over there. Next what we're going to do is, I'm going to work on the, first of all, I'm going to turn my oven to 350. Turn my oven to 350. You can go over there. Just go on over there. Okay, now here we go, scoot it up. Now we're going to work on this, y'all. Okay. Now with this is the ravioli I was telling y'all about that I had to boil, y'all. So, I had to boil them and we had to drain them. So, you'll be working. I had the chicken broth. I went and got the chicken broth. That's one thing I had forgot to tell y'all about is the chicken broth. Add some chicken broth. Flavor, y'all. Any recipe that you do and it calls for water or whatever and you cooking with beef, pork, or whatever. Sometimes you use chicken broth instead of the water. Sometimes you use water and chicken broth or water and beef broth or just the broth. Whatever you, it depends on what you're cooking. You make up your mind on what kind of broth you want to use. You know what I'm saying? So this is chicken Alfredo, so I'm using chicken broth. You can use chicken broth or anything. Beef broth is a little different because it's a little brown. So sometimes you don't want your entrees and your dishes brown. You know what I'm saying? So like if I was to use beef broth in this chicken Alfredo, oh, it would look a mess. Y'all, I'm making a mess. I'm squirting shit all over the oven. I can be sloppy when I cook, y'all, but that's okay. It gets cleaned up. You feel me? Messy cook make good food. You feel me? I ain't into fronting like I'm all neat and shit. Hell to the no. I do okay. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody complaining. I do okay in the kitchen when it comes to being neat. But I can't cook. You feel what I'm saying? Your girl can burn, so it don't matter. Okay? Once that is done, I want to put a half a stick of butter in there. Now, like I said, this is my way. Butter, margarine, whatever. This is margarine. Like I said, I don't really use butter. I don't like real butter. I don't know. I don't like to use real butter. And all my cakes and stuff, I use margarine. I use Imperial on everything. You know, I'm not the butter person. I can't stand it. When we were poor and it had nothing, and my mama used to bring that welfare butter, y'all. Oh, that butter was so fucking nasty. I did not eat it. I would not eat that butter. I just had to wait till food stamp day came, and she got us some other margarine or something, some knockoff margarine. You feel me? I wasn't no picky child, but I damn sure wasn't finna eat that welfare butter. No way. That butter was nasty. I tasted that shit one time. I'm like, hey, damn, that shit nasty. It tastes like ass. I don't know what ass tastes like. That's what they tell me. You feel me? I ain't never ate no ass. Yeah, now. But I smell ass, so yeah, I ate it. You know how you sniff stuff so hard that you done ate it? I done been in a class with a motherfucker growing up and smelled some ass and ate some ass because I sniffed too hard. You feel me? And it got in my throat like. So yeah, I do know what ass smell like, you know. And y'all know, I think Parmesan cheese, it's a nutty cheese and it's a weird cheese. I'm melting the butter, y'all. Parmesan cheese is so weird because it's so stinky. It's nutty and the shit smells like ass. It really does. It smells just like ass to me, Parmesan cheese, but I love it to death. I do love me some Parmesan cheese, y'all, on top of my any pasta dish. And I'm not a pasta eater, but if I do, I gotta have that. I gotta have that. I eat pasta, but not a lot of it because I get full too quick. Y'all know why. Y'all know why, but hey, I do my fizzle. Now it's time to season it. Well, I just got those ingredients in it, you know. First of all, I do want to add something before so I can cook it on down with it. Oh, shit. Y'all can see that. Oh, my baby is tape. His tape is recording this. Say hi to sweet babies, Miki.
Hey, y'all.
That's my baby, Mika. I'm adding a teaspoon of maybe a little bit over a teaspoon of garlic. Y'all know I love garlic, okay? Y'all already know, and I'm about to add another one. 2 teaspoons of garlic, okay? This is a big dish, though. This is a lot of stuff, y'all. Look how much of that stuff is in there. All them noodles and shit. That's a lot. That's a big-ass pan. That's my copper pan. I love cooking with my copper joints, you feel me? Okay. Let me cut that down a little bit. Okay. Now the seasonings. I'm using ground mustard. Ground mustard. Pepper. This just gonna be a quick meal, y'all. It might not seem quick to y'all, but it is. It is. Teaspoon of salt. Just a teaspoon. Regular salt. And I use the magic seasoning on zucchini. On this, I'm gonna use the Morton season all salt. Yeah. Okay. Of course, the accent to wake up the flavor. Just a little bit. Yeah, I got MSG. If you don't eat MSG, don't eat it. This is my food. I eat, put what I want on my shit. You feel me? You put what you want on your shit. Don't ever let nobody tell you what you can put on your shit. If they tell you, just let them talk. Who gives a fuck? They ain't eating it. You feel me? This is the roasted garlic and herb, y'all. Little adobo, just a little.
I know y'all like, she could have kept that. Nope, nope. Everything matters when it comes to seasoning, y'all. Everything. To me, anyway.
And make sure y'all get y'all a spoon or a spatula or something, because you don't want to break up your raviolis when you cooking them with the seasonings and stuff. Because I like to use my wooden or plastic things on this non-scratch stuff. Because this is the expensive cookware. This ain't no cheap shit. Y'all feel me? Y'all know I buy gadgets. I buy some of everything. I can't help it. I love to cook. And even though I can't get around like I used to, I just love to have it on hand. Yes, yes. I'm a junkie when it comes to buying things like this, you know. But it's something you can use for the rest of your life. This is like lifetime warranty shit, you know. You get them old ass pot and pans from the dollar store. Mm-mm. Back when I was young, I think I only got one pot set from the dollar store. Never again. Never. Those skillets ain't shit. I don't even think they aluminum. But that shit ain't no good. Y'all see how the seasoning going in the chicken broth
It's getting infused in the chicken broth. See, look, Sean. See how that chicken broth looking? Yep. That's how you want it. And then the raviolis, I didn't let them boil that long. You know, like you're supposed to let it simmer for about 5 minutes. I left them in there probably about three, you know, after they was, you know, I let them simmer for about three. Because I didn't want them to overcook when we put them in here and the filling fall out of them. See, they filled up with spinach and three cheese. Okay. Next, what we got on this. You're going to add a little milk. Now, I don't measure this stuff. That's the stove. It reached 350. It's letting me know, y'all. It's letting me girl know. Oh, shit. You add a little milk. I don't measure nothing, y'all. I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell y'all. Okay? And guess what I'm coming around with? Shot of vinegar, y'all. Couple of shots. See, y'all don't know, but y'all that never cook with vinegar, I'm telling y'all, it wakes up the fucking flavor, man. Y'all think I'm playing. Vinegar is the shit in almost everything. I won't say everything. Your meats, though. Your dishes. I don't even know what. Oh, Parmesan cheese, y'all. I'm sorry. I don't know how much. You got to do it for your taste, okay? Just sprinkle the cover of the dish, okay? That's why it's in the pot anyway. You know, you add more later. You can use fresh shredded Parmesan. I use that sometimes. But for some reason, I like the powder kind better. But the shredded I use sometimes, and sometimes I use both. But this time, I just bought the powdered kind. I didn't want to buy the shredded kind. Sometimes I get mad at the shredded kind because I don't like the way the shredded kind melts. I don't know if y'all know what I'm talking about, but I do not like the way that cheese melts. Like, whenever a dish calls for Parmesan, like chicken Parmesan, I always add mozzarella with the shredded Parmesan. I always do. Like, even with chicken Parmesan, when I make chicken Parmesan, I might make that for y'all one day. When I make chicken Parmesan, what I'll do is use mozzarella cheese. And if I'm not using the grated Parmesan, what I do, y'all, is I use, I get the mozzarella cheese and put it in a bowl and use that powder grated that you just seen me use. I use that in the Parmesan, the mozzarella shredded cheese, and I mix it up in a bowl and sprinkle that on top of the chicken. So that can be with the Parmesan, you know what I'm saying? And it tastes so good. I'm pouring a Bertolli in now, y'all. Just right now, one can, because I got to put the chicken in there. Just one can. I want to make sure I get the sauce going and the base before I put the chicken in, you know. Just a minute, sweet babies. Hello, sweet babies. We're back. The flash on the camera isn't working right now, so I'm hoping y'all can see somebody. Somebody, I ain't saying no names, forgot to, I'm putting the diced chicken breast in there now. I like mine meaty. I might not need it all, though. I may not, you think? Mm-hmm. I don't know, because I like mine meaty. I ain't gonna lie. I don't know. Over here, y'all, over here we got the dish we're gonna use for the zucchini. And what you need to do is put olive oil in the bottom of your skillet. Just cover the bottom of your skillet. Olive oil gives it a nice flavor also, okay? Okay. And you gotta let that heat up, so. Let that heat up. This is another copper pot I got, y'all. Okay. Now over here we need to stir it. Remember the oven is on 350 because I'm gonna put this in the oven. That's another reason I didn't want to overcook anything. That's why I didn't make them raviolis all the way like that. Now, y'all see I didn't season that chicken, so this is not over-seasoned yet. It's not going to be over-seasoned. I'm just playing sweet babies. But y'all get what I'm saying. I'm going to add more seasoning, but it's not going to be too fucked up with seasoning. See, that ain't enough chicken to me. We just going to use it all. Look at that meaty-ass shit. That's my shit. Now, when I was little, my fat ass used to pick the meat out of shit. I ain't playing. That's a lot of ravioli, though, to me. They big, too, ain't they? Mm-hmm. That's some big-ass raviolis, y'all. And they stuffed with cheese and spinach. And, you know, and one thing I hate about
people that make any chicken Alfredo, I can't stand for it not to be saucy. I can't stand that. That's just like scampi sauce. I make mine so different because I don't use white wine. I just use white vinegar and lemon juice. You know, you can use that, omit the wine. Everybody don't use wine, and I don't. So, I just can't stand it. Like the scampi, when people make scampi with noodles and the sauce is gone, it's just coated on the fucking noodles. And I'm not a pasta eater either. So that doesn't go sit right with me. Y'all feel me? Y'all see that? That's how people would leave it. But guess what? Not Ms. Carla, baby. Because I'll kick it up a notch on your ass. You feel me? So right now, what I'm going to do is add some more chicken broth. Yes, yes. Chicken broth got that flavor, y'all. That flavor. That flavor in it. And it gives it that smoke. Like when you slow cooking, because I got it on like a medium low. If that makes any sense, I don't know shit. Medium low, do medium low make sense to you, nigga?
No.
Well, shit, that's what I got on. I made up a new medium low. It is a such thing as medium low.
No, it's low medium.
No, it's not. Low medium, bitch. How she gonna say it's low medium? Here go another jar. I don't think I'm gonna use that whole jar because what I forgot to do is, my bad, y'all. That other jar, y'all already know. Instead of pouring water in it, here, pour chicken broth in it, right? Y'all already know what comes next. I know all you black folks know what's coming next, right? Hold on, hold on. Oh, you hell. Shake, 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 right? We getting all that shit we paid for, right? Oh, shit, I got some cooking to do. My bad. I'll be... Hold on, y'all. Don't gotta fall. Okay. Now, we coming over here to the zucchini. Hold on. We letting that cool down a little bit, y'all. We ain't going for the okie doke. Not with no hot-ass olive oil like that. You let it cool down. That's one thing. When you see something, Oh, shit. Oh shit. When you see something heating up, y'all, and I need to get them silicone things to go on these handles that doesn't have, you know, the heat resistant handles. I need to get that because I am so clumsy in the kitchen, y'all. Super clumsy. My daughter shaking her big ass head. Yeah, I am. I'm not going to lie. Y'all see how saucy that is, y'all? Y'all see that, sweet babies? Now hold on. We'll be right back, sweet babies. Sweet babies, we're back. And this is why I'm putting these onions. Remember, these onions is got water on them, so this grease gonna be popping. Yes, because they were frozen. My lady ass freezes onions when I'm cutting them up for other dishes. Sometimes I even buy them from that company I showed y'all, that swine. I buy them motherfuckers. And the reason why, because I don't do it all the time. Like this time I bought some colored peppers. I gotta hurry up and slice them up and freeze them before they go bad. I was gonna make some stuffed peppers, but I don't know yet. About a teaspoon or maybe two, maybe a tablespoon and a half of garlic. Well, that's me, what I'm putting in there. I can't tell y'all what to put in y'all's shit. I can't. I don't know why I just said that. I'm just letting y'all know what I put in there. Now, I'm getting this a little spicy, so I'm putting a little red pepper flakes in it. Y'all know I got a lot. Remember, I had a lot of zucchini and squash. So, now, over here, the Alfredo is on low. Turn it on lower. It's low. It's on low. We're going to have it on low. And that's going to be simmering that Alfredo sauce in there while I'm cooking the zucchini and stuff. Okay. I have to turn that heat down because you don't want garlic burns. I don't know, y'all that don't cook, I want to let y'all know garlic burns quick, especially when you're sautéing it, but you do want to put that cooking flavor to it in some dishes. Like this is vegetable, so I want that little roasted flavor, okay? And one thing about that, you can season your onions and stuff. Just roast the garlic and herb, okay? Roast the garlic and herb. Remember, we already seasoned the vegetables, so we don't need no lot of seasoning in the peppers, okay? Just a little bit. Just a little bit, y'all. Okay?
Just a little bit. Mm-hmm. Y'all see how low I got? I don't want to burn that shit. You don't. Then I want to put a half a stick of butter in there, or margarine. Y'all know what I told y'all, what I use. I got to take that glove off. That glove is all buttered up, you feel me? All buttered up, y'all. I want to melt that on up in there. You feel me? Up a little bit. You don't gotta do them long, y'all. Not that long, you know. Okay, I'm gonna let these cook down and I'll be right back, y'all. And we're back, sweet babies. Y'all watching? Y'all see that garlic bread in a Ziploc bag frozen that I made homemade the other day that I showed y'all in my video? Bless you.
Thank you.
What video was that I had that in? Was that that spicy mussel with the tomato sauce video? I made that garlic bread. That was that big long French bread I bought from Walmart that I made. And I made garlic bread, homemade garlic parmesan bread. That's it right there. You freeze it up just like they freeze theirs in the store. And when you need it, you take it out piece by piece. We cut ours up because it's just me and my baby. You feel me? Now back over here to these onions that's sauteing, y'all. Look how they look, y'all, with their butter. Nice and buttery. Look at that. Don't that look gorgeous? Gorgeous. Okay, now you add chicken broth. Little chicken broth. Okay, now here come my favorite. Vinegar, y'all. Vinegar. And remember the vegetables already got that vinegar taste on them because I tossed them in that when I made that seasoning on them, you know. And I don't think I'm gonna make them all. I don't know yet. Here, I'll show y'all. I hate to get my hands dirty. Let me grab another glove, y'all. I hate that. I don't know. I know it sounds crazy, but I'm not the type that like to stick my hand in dressing, meatloaf. I do, but I use gloves. That's one thing. I use gloves. I'm telling y'all, I use gloves, especially when I got diagnosed with HS. I don't know. It's a bacteria disease, and it ain't got nothing to do with cooking and stuff, but cleanliness when it comes to bacteria, sanitizing and stuff, that's just me. So I use gloves for every fucking thing now, you know. Okay, my grandmama look at me like, what the hell, gloves, baby? What you got on some gloves for? I probably would have got hit in my head. She see me wearing some gloves making some damn food. I saved a little bit, y'all. Not much. Not much. It can be for another dinner. You feel me? I'm going to cook that down a little bit. And then I'm going to add them potatoes in there, y'all. Them potatoes. Yeah, we're going to cook this down a little bit, y'all. Take the glove off so I can hold that wood spoon. Still got the glove on the other hand, though. I stay strapped. You feel me? Strapped with that silicone. You feel me? And when I was having sex, I stayed strapped with that silicone. You feel me? Latex and silicone. You feel me? Whichever one. Y'all better stay strapped if y'all doing the do. Public service announcement from your girl, Ms. Carlababy. You feel me? While cooking. It don't matter. That's how we get down, sweet baby. We save a life. Teach one, each one, teach one. You feel me? Each one, teach one. I always think of that, y'all. Y'all see all that good garlic going in there. Y'all know I am a garlic fanatic. I don't know. I just am, y'all. Look at it. Look at all that garlic and onions. Oh, my Lord, y'all. Jesus, that squash and that zucchini. You feel me? That zucchini and that squash. Zucchini. And some of y'all would say zucchini. You feel me? Zucchini.
And I'm going to tell y'all, sweet babies, I'm doing this during the cooking video because I missed it the last mukbangs. Yeah, I got a word of the day. May I say two words, maybe more. Let me tell y'all something. Do y'all know the difference between an O and an A? I think y'all do. So the next time I see one of y'all saying tomato or potato, I'm calling you out. I'm tired of this shit, y'all. I'm tired. I love y'all. But please stop butchering them words to potato and tomato. Y'all gonna think the others, have the others thinking that we retarded. Straight up. Now I understand some people, you know, southern people that's older. Like my mom and them, they butcher words. But some of them did their thing. They took care of home and they didn't, you know. But we got people that graduated, went to college, and they still saying potato and tomato like they were slaves. Y'all was not no slaves. Y'all stop talking like that, you know. It's rather funny, I'm not gonna lie, but goddamn it, tomato and potato. But if you wanna say it, fuck it. You do what you want. You know what I'm saying? That's y'all. Like me, I cuss. Better nobody tell me I can't. No, I'm just joking with y'all when I bring up this shit, because like I said, my mama did it, but I just don't think nobody that was born after 1970 should say that slave talk. You feel me? To me, that just take us way back, y'all. I don't know what y'all think. Leave it in comments if y'all think that shit take us way back, or y'all can't help it, or do you do it on purpose? I don't know. I just don't see potato and tomato being done on accident. Now, I can see screw and straight and stuff like that. That's different, but putting an A and an O at the end and stuff, that's a little bit much, y'all. Okay, y'all see how I'm sauteing them down a little bit? Huh? Y'all see that? I'm going to do them a little bit more, and I'm coming right back to you, baby. Y'all work on potato and tomato, and I'll be back. And we're back, baby. We're coming back with the potatoes. We're putting potatoes in here. If y'all want to put potatoes, y'all can, but I'm putting potatoes up in mine. Now, mind y'all, I did roast these potatoes for real. I roasted them like a week ago. Y'all see the little peppers on them? Y'all see that? The peppers? Y'all see those sweet babies? I'm saving some for the other zucchini I got. The colorful peppers, because I roasted them for a long time on low. In the oven, y'all. First, I did it on low, and then I turned them up so they can get a little crispy. Oh, God. That looks so good, y'all, don't it? Don't it, y'all? I put that zucchini and squash down. And now we're going to get that how I did it. Y'all see that? You don't want to overpower with potatoes. You want to make the, you don't want to make the potatoes as far as the shell. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to coat this off. The potatoes are already seasoned, y'all. Everything is already good and seasoned. Y'all know I eat for flavor. Y'all know I ain't playing. Look at all them beautiful colors and stuff, y'all. She almost dropped the phone in the dish, y'all. We've been having Samsung, zucchini. Okay. And I'm going to put that on low and let that simmer. And I'll be right back, y'all, and finishing the Alfredo up. I'll be right back, sweet babies. And we're back, sweet baby. Ms. Carla Baby's Kitchen. Here we go. That was a commercial break. Here we go. We back. I got to show you these trolleys, these spice trolleys I bought. Because y'all just don't know. Your girl got so many spices. I bought two of these motherfuckers, though. They need to be clean, but I bought two of them, y'all. And this ain't half of the spices I got. I got cabinet full of fucking spices. I'm crazy, okay? Okay, another thing y'all need to add is parsley on top. I'm going to just put the parsley on top because it got spinach throughout the dish. Okay? Okay. And one other seasoning I would like to put in here that I'll use on everything too, and it brings out the flavor. Lemon pepper, y'all. Lemon pepper. This also made by Morton. Season all. Morton. Just a little lemon pepper. Yes, I'm slinging it all over the stove. I told y'all how I get down in the field. This is the last step to this chicken Alfredo. Chicken Alfredo with raviolis. You feel me? What raviolis? Trying to be on my Italian shit today. You feel me? My black Italian. My blood Italian. We're going to call it blood Italian, okay? A black Italian is a blood Italian. Okay? I'm the first blood Italian to hit this motherfucking earth, y'all heard? Okay? Oh yeah, y'all. Y'all already know. I'm a fucking chef. If y'all think I'm a good chef, put it in the comments, y'all. We gonna do this. We did this when I first started cooking. Put it in the comments, y'all. I'm a fucking chef. Hashtag I'm a fucking chef. If you don't cuss, put effing with the stars. Y'all already know what the asterisk marks. Put it in there. I'm a effing chef. You feel me? If you don't cuss, put I'm a fucking chef. You feel me? I mean, effing chef. My bad, y'all. Everybody ain't bad like me. Ain't nobody bad like me. Girl, I'm just cool. Dun, dun, dun. Y'all remember that shit? Ain't nobody bad like me. Morris Day, y'all. Don't try to act like I'm the only old motherfucker in here. I know y'all up in hole. Okay, now here's the mozzarella cheese. Yes, 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 y'all. Haha, y'all thought that was just for the top. Nope, that's for the, what do you call that? Stir-in. You gotta stir in some. I say about a cup for something big like this. This is a big old fucking thing. I don't even know what to call it. A big copper casserole, oven, skillet. You can do everything in this motherfucker. And I bought 2 Dutch ovens, y'all, for fucking $55 off Sam's Club. A 7-quart and a 4-quart. And they are so beautiful, y'all. I can't wait to use them. I was going to use them today, but I decided to use one in both of my coppers. Both of my copper. Y'all see how that mozzarella string. And now those of y'all that want to spice up y'all Alfredo sauce, you got to make sure you put mozzarella cheese and parm up in it for it to be cheesy. See, I like my shit cheesy. Motherfuckers that taste my shit be like, damn, now you might gain some weight. Y'all know I can't eat much anyway, but I don't have no problem feeding y'all. Y'all want to come and get a plate, you feel me? I don't mind feeding nobody as long as they come get it. I don't do meals on wheels, y'all feel me? Fed it, I might do for y'all. But no meals on wheels. I don't know why I feel funny with these turned over on the top. I know that's petty, y'all. I know y'all like, girl, shut the fuck up and put that shit together. I will. I hear y'all. I hear y'all some baby. Okay, this is the last. Make sure y'all even it. Even it. See that? Even it. I had let it simmer all that time, the chicken chunks. Remember, I didn't season the chicken chunks because we already seasoned the ravioli and the Alfredo sauce very fucking well. So we didn't. That's my medicine alarm. So we didn't need to season the chicken chunks. So what you need to do is put them chicken chunks in there and let it simmer. Now you can cook the chicken chunks ahead of time when you cook that sauce and let them cook down in there and add the ravioli last. But this is the way I did it today. I do stuff different every time I fucking cook, y'all. I do my gravy different every time I cook. That's why I say it's so weird. I know y'all like, damn, bitch, the cheese, this it. Cause I know my daughter be fussing. She's so weird. Anybody else be more cheese? Not her. She be, that's too much cheese, mama. Won't you? Yeah, she will. She looking at me now. I'm like, bitch, that's enough. Okay, that is enough though. That's enough. Okay. Then after that, what you do, you put some Parmesan cheese. Cause after all, it's Alfredo. You know Alfredo gotta have Parmesan in it. Even on the top. I like the powder. So there we go. There we go. Okay. Now, for it to look nice, parsley. I don't know. I don't ever taste parsley, I guess. People say you do taste it, but I don't ever taste that shit. Not unless I'm just being greedy. I don't know, y'all. Y'all tell me in the comments if y'all know what parsley tastes like. I even tasted fresh parsley, and I don't taste shit. Cilantro neither. Now, cilantro have a little taste, but parsley, I don't know. That's it. Now that's gonna go in the oven, y'all, okay, and get bubbly on my ass. And I'm gonna come back and show y'all the finished product. Remember, we got the bread, we got the potatoes, the zucchini, the yellow squash sauteed, and the motherfucking garlic butter. We'll be back, sweet babies, to show you the finished product. We're back, sweet babies. This is the final results of my chicken Alfredo with the 3 cheese spinach stuffed raviolis. Get out of here. And I'm fussing at my dog. I'm sorry, y'all. She know we don't play that shit in the kitchen shit. Okay, so, and we have here my vegetables. zucchini with roasted potatoes and yellow squash with onions and garlic and butter and a dash of vinegar and Cajun spices. Mika, you off. With Cajun spices, with that, you got a kick because I put them red peppers up in that motherfucker. Y'all see all the, you're not on it, right? Don't worry about her. It got all them spices on there, y'all. Look at them. We'll be right back when we plate this, y'all. And we're back, sweet babies. I just wanted to show y'all the stuff that I be getting for Sam Club that y'all be seeing me with. This little restaurant stuff. These had 125 in it. This one we got left. We still got a lot left. These compartment plates. And the ones that you cover up. This had 250 in it. 250. And this got a lot in it. We got the packs in there. I don't know, but you can do that. And then we got the tissue paper, the little restaurant shit. Y'all, I told you I got everything. Shit. I just buy shit. You feel me? Now, what y'all been waiting on? Let me get this countertop clean, y'all. Look at all this stuff I buy. I'm crazy. Look, I just buy shit. Look at the countertop. Pineapple. Look at pineapples and shit. The fuck? Okay, this is in a paper plate, y'all, but this is the final result of this. Ooh, look at that cheese, y'all. Y'all know I ain't finna eat all this. I would do a mukbang, but I'm so tired, sweet baby. So I'm gonna end this, and I'm about to chow down. I love y'all, and here go the plate once again. And I will see y'all later by the cat. And you can't beat this with a bat. But put, okay, that was so chatty. That was so chatty, y'all. Hit the bell so you can get notified to get invited to my house. And know when you come, you'll be getting that flavor, playa.
Peace.
Motorsport, yeah. Put that thing in sports. Shout it bad, pop it like a court. You a dork, never been a sport. Pull up, jumping out the court. Cotton candy, my cup tastes like the fair. Straight up there, we didn't take the stairs. Face my fears, gave my mama tears. Mama, shifting gears, on the Nokia Sears. Motorsport, put that thing in sports. Shout it bad, pop it like a court. You a dork, never been a sport. Pull up, jumping out the court. Cotton candy, my cup tastes like the fair. Straight up there, we didn't take the stairs. Face my fears, gave my mama tears. Mama, shifting gears, on the Nokia Sears. Motorsport, put that thing in sports. Shout it bad, pop it like a court. Pop it.